हाय हाय एवरीवन, हाय स्टूडेंट्स, हाय स्टूडेंट्स, हेलो एवरीवन, कैन यू हियर मी?
यस मैम,
यस मैम।
ओके, okay, we have stopped here. Okay, what? Okay, who is going to tell me what we have studied in the last class? Second chapter. Hello, can you hear me? Yes, chapter's name is The Introduction to Fibers, Dyeing and Printing. So we have studied about what we have studied. What is textile fiber? Can anyone say? Hello, students. Can you hear me? Someone please say what is textile fiber? Niti, anyone? Please tell me what is textile fiber.
Unit of matter which is usually at least 100 times longer to its thickness. Basically, unit of all textile fiber molecule. Molecule is a fiber. Fiber are called polymers.
Okay. It is a unit of matter. That means atom, which is usually at least 100 times longer to its thickness. And the basic unit of fiber is a molecule, which means the group of atoms bonded together. Okay, then who is going to tell me the classification of textile fibers? We have classified into two. What is that? Malavika, can you say what are the classification of textile fibers?
Fibers are divided into two, natural and man-made. The okay. Natural is divided into cellulosic, protein, mineral.
Okay, due to its chemical composition, they are classified into cellulosic,
protein and mineral.
Protein and mineral. Okay, and what about man-made?
Cellulosic, synthetic, protein, mineral and metallic.
Okay. We can see the composition of natural fibers, like natural cellulosic fibers are cotton, jute, flax, hemp, banana fiber and pinna fiber, etc. They all are cellulosic fiber. So now we are going to say about natural fibers. Natural fibers are obtained from the natural resources like plant, vegetable, animal hair and natural minerals. So I have told you in the last class that natural fibers are obtained from plant, vegetables, animal hairs, and natural minerals. So, the vegetable and plant origin are generally cellulosic in chemical composition. See, fibers from vegetable and plants are cellulosic fibers. And animal fibers are protein in chemical composition, which means the fibers are, we obtain these fibers from animal hairs, right? Tell me what is cellulosic fibers. What do you mean by which fibers are cellulosic? From where we are getting cellulosic fibers? Can anyone say? Anna, please tell me what is, from where we are getting cellulosic fibers? From? Your sound is?
Fibers from vegetables, plants.
Okay, fibers from vegetables and plants are cellulosic fibers. Okay, then what all fibers are? Can you give me an example of animal fibers? Wool, silk, camel hair, angora rabbit hair, pashmina goat hair, all these are animal fibers. And cotton, flax, jute, fur, hemp, banana fiber is a natural cellulosic fiber. And asbestos are the naturally occurring mineral. And it is resistant to fire. And it is also, we can say it is resistant to fire also. And now we are going to discuss about the natural fibers. Some of natural fibers like cotton, jute, silk, flax, and wool. Okay. So before that, someone please tell me what is natural fibers? What are natural fibers? And from where we obtain natural fibers? Steffi, can you say that?
From natural fibers are obtained from plants, animal hair, etc.
Okay, then someone please tell me why they are called cellulosic fiber. Who can say that?
Because they are obtained from plants and vegetables.
Okay, they are called as cellulosic fibers. And Malavika, why they are called as protein fiber? Why? Can you say? Yeah, because Malavika.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
I could not
tell me. Okay. Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Tell me why can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Why we are saying that wool, silk, camel hair, angora rabbit on.
They are obtained from animal hairs.
Okay. Because they are made from animal hairs. Okay. And the naturally occurring mineral fiber is asbestos. Okay. Now we are going to discuss the properties of cotton. Now we are going to discuss the properties of cotton. Okay. It is a natural fiber, natural cellulosic fiber. Cotton is a natural cellulosic fiber, which is obtained from the seed hair of cotton. You can see this is the cotton seed. It's a cotton plant, raw cotton in it, cotton seed. And the cotton is obtained from the seed hair of the cotton plant, cotton. Okay, and the cross section of cotton fiber is kidney shaped. In the text, the cross section and all are shown, but I know some of you don't have textbooks, so I'll draw it for you. One minute. Okay, the cross section of cotton is like this, kidney shaped. Is it clear to everyone? The cross section of a cotton fiber is in the shape of, it is a kidney shaped fiber. Okay. Okay. And in India, the main cotton producing states are Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, and West Bengal. And the length of the cotton fiber ranges from 10 millimeter to 65 millimeter. We are discussing the properties, okay? So the length of the fiber ranges from 10 mm to 65 mm. Okay, then cotton fibers are hygroscopic in nature. Hygroscopic means it can absorb moisture from air. They are hygroscopic in nature, which means that it can absorb around 8.5% of moisture from their dry weight. So their absorbency is very high. From that we can understand their absorbency is very high, because they can absorb 8.5% of moisture of their dry weight. So they are called hygroscopic. So cotton is hygroscopic in nature. It is a property. It is suitable for wearing in hot and humid weather. Because of this property, they have the high hygroscopic nature. Because of the property, this cotton we can wear in hot and humid weather. It is comfortable to wear in hot and humid weather. Cotton fibers have the ability to conduct heat energy and can withstand high ironing temperatures. See, they have the ability to conduct heat. So if you are ironing cotton in high temperature, they can withstand the temperature. The strength of the cotton fiber is good, and the strength increases when the fiber is wet. Normally the cotton's strength is good, but when it is wet, the strength increases. Understood? Those are the properties. So because of the strength, this cotton clothes are more durable. Durable. And the other property of cotton is cotton fibers are not affected by alkalis. Alkalis means the base which can dissolve in water, and mild beaches. We can use mild beaches, like we can use detergents and all in cotton fabric. So they are not affected easily. So that the cotton fiber can laundered at home using detergents, etc. Then the next property of cotton is cotton fibers can be affected by direct sunlight due to photochemical degradation in the presence of atmospheric oxygen and moisture. What do you mean by photochemical degradation? It is the chemical effect of light. These cotton fibers can affect the direct sunlight due to photochemical degradation with the presence of oxygen and moisture. This causes the yellowness of the fabric. For example, you can see your white cotton fabrics which you are not used for long period. Then after a long period, you can see that fabric becomes yellow in color. That's an example for photochemical degradation. Understood? The cotton fabrics which are not used for long time can be colored as yellow, and can be in yellow color. You can see that. Then this is the cotton fiber, the cotton plant, This is a picture of a cotton in a cotton plant, and this is a cross section of a cotton. So, who is going to explain the properties? What I have told you in this class about cotton? Tell me, Niti, can you explain the properties of cotton? What yes. you have understood from this?
Natural cellulotic fibers.
They are natural. Cotton fiber, okay.
Cotton plant.
I can't hear you.
Obtained from cotton plants.
Okay, they are obtained from seed hair of cotton. Okay, then.
Cross section of cotton fiber is in kidney shape.
Shaped, okay.
Then, they are seen in Maharashtra, okay. Madhya Pradesh.
Okay. Okay. The India, the mainly cotton producing states are all these states: Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, West Bengal, and all. Then, what are the next properties? Who can say that? All other. Anna, can you say the next property? The other properties of cotton.
To wear hot and humid weather.
Okay, it is suitable for wearing hot and humid weather. And then it have Sharon, please tell me.
Have the ability to conduct heat.
Okay, that is a property, and the strength of the fiber is also good. It is normally good, and if the fiber is wet, the strength increases. Then, Malavika, can you say the other properties?
It is not affected by alkalis and mild bleaches.
Okay.
They become affected by direct sunlight due to photochemical degradation.
Okay. This causes the yellowness of the fabric.
Cotton fibers, yarns, and fabrics can be easily dyed with different classes of dyes like direct, reactive, wet, and sulfur dyes.
Okay, they can, They can be easily dyed, right? With different classes of dyes like direct, reactive, wet, and sulfur dyes. About dyes, we are going to study in the next topics, okay? Then I'll explain more about that. The next natural fiber is jute. You can see a picture of a jute plant here. See? Can anyone see a jute plant picture? This jute fiber is obtained from the stem of a jute plant. Understood? The jute fiber is obtained from the stem of the jute plant. Okay. Jute fibers are also cellulosic in nature, like cotton. It can absorb moisture. See, they are cellulosic in nature. Like cotton, they can absorb moisture. Sorry, the spelling is, there is a spelling mistake. This is absorb. They can absorb moisture. The jute fiber have excellent strength and low elongation. It can be understood by the picture. Everyone have seen jute fiber, right? Mainly we are using jute fibers for carpets, bags, sacks, etc. So from seeing the examples, what can you say? Can anyone say there any other properties like its elasticity? How will be its elasticity? When we stretch the jute fiber, what will be the effect? Will it stretch or what? What can you say? Can anyone say? Other. Malavika, can you say when we elongate jute fibers?
Huh? They are not much elastic.
Yeah. Yes, they have low elongation, right? Jute fiber have excellent strength and low elongation. They have excellent strength. That because of that, they are using in carpets, bags, sacks, etc. And low elongation. Okay, that's why we are not using jute in our clothes as a cloth. The strength of jute fiber are higher than cotton and elongate less than cotton on application of weight. This property makes it suitable to be used in bags and sacks to carry heavy weight. But due to roughness and stiff handle of jute fibers, it's not used for clothing. As I have told you, we are not using jute fibers for clothing purpose, but used for carpets, bags, sacks, and industrial applications. So it is simple. What is the properties of jute? Who is going to say the properties of jute? Sharon, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, can you say the properties of jute?
Yeah, jute fiber is obtained from the stem of a jute plant.
Okay, you can see a jute fiber here.
It is cellulosic in nature, like cotton.
Okay.
And it can absorb moisture.
Okay.
It is excellent strength and low elongation.
Okay.
Strength of the fiber are higher than cotton.
Okay, and Sana, please tell me, for what we are used jute fibers? For what purpose we are using jute fibers? Sana, I think your video is off. I can't see you. Sharon have said that she's having a network issue. And Sana, what happened to you?
I'm network issue.
Okay, network issue. Okay, can you please say for what purpose we are using jute fibers? Can you hear me, Sana?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so what purpose, like for what we are using jute fibers? I've said you in the class.
To make bags, sacks.
Sacks, okay, carpets, bags, etc. Okay, and from where we get jute fiber? From where the jute fiber is obtained?
From the jute plant. From the stem of the jute plant.
Okay, of a jute plant. Okay, right. Then next we are going to discuss the properties of jute flax fiber. Okay. These are the natural fibers. Okay, natural cellulosic fibers. Flax. Now what is flax? Flax fiber is thick, regular fiber with a subdued luster. It is a thick and regular fiber with a subdued luster. You can see in the picture, the luster is don't have bright luster, right? Someone please tell me, yes or no? What you can see in this picture, the fiber of the flax, from that, what you can see? Is it lustrous? Or Malavika? Yeah, answer me. It is not lustrous, right? Okay. The color of the fabric fiber varies from light blonde to grayish blonde. Yeah, the fiber can be bleached and dyed to any shade like cotton. Like cotton, we can dye this flax fiber into any color. Like we can color it into any black, white, any colors we can use for flax. And this flax fiber is the fiber, the fabric which you are obtaining from the flax is linen fabric. Understood? So we are using linen clothes for shirts and all. Who all knows linen fabric? Who all have seen linen fabric? No one knows? What is linen? It is commonly used for shirts. Shirts and all. And the length of the fiber ranges from 10 centimeter to 100 centimeters. The length of the linen fiber is from 10 centimeter to 100 centimeters. And the cross section of the fiber shows that flax fibers are polygonal in shape. You can see they are flat shaped. The cross section. This is the cross section. In this, you can see the fibers are polygonal in shape, polygonal or flat shape. Right? They are polygonal in shape. The fabric made from flax, known as linen, which is used for clothing. Yeah, we are using linen cloth as a fabric, and it is made from flax fiber. Okay. Like cotton fabrics, flax can also absorb moisture and it is resistant to alkalis. It also have the same property of cotton because it can absorb moisture like cotton itself. And it is resistant to alkalis. It is dissolved in water. Okay. Now the next. Okay, someone please tell me what is flax. What is flax fiber? Malavika, please tell me what is flax fiber.
Regular fiber with subdued luster.
Okay.
It can be bleached and dyed to any shade like cotton.
Okay.
Cross section of the fiber shows that they are polygonal in shape.
Okay.
They are made from flax linen. It creases easily due to its stiff nature.
Okay, now Meghna, tell me. Okay, thank you. Meghna, please tell me the other properties.
The flax fiber is thick, and from flax, the linen is made, and it's cellulosic in nature like the cotton. It creases easily because it's due to its stiff nature.
Okay, what do you understand from that? Flax fibers, like linen fabric, creases easily due to stiff nature. That means when we fold it on that fabric, we can see the lines on that fabric. Understood? Like a paper. When you fold the fabric, the lines are shown. Lines are seen, right? Because of its stiff nature. Because the linen fabric is stiff. Understood? And this is the major difference between cotton and flax. Cotton will not crease because it is soft, and linen is stiff, so it creases. Okay? And flax fiber absorbs moisture like cotton also. Same as these properties of flax and cotton is same. Not much same, it's much more similar. And next, we are going to study about the properties of wool. Okay, wool. Yeah. This is the wool fiber, which is not cleaned. You can see wool fiber. And the woolen cushion you can see here. Okay, wool fiber is obtained from the fleece of domesticated sheep. It is obtained from fleece of domesticated sheep. Understood? It is obtained from the fleece of domesticated sheep. And it is a natural protein fiber. Because it is obtained from animal hair, it is called as natural protein fiber. The length of the wool fibers ranges from 5 cm for fine wool to 35 cm for the coarse and long wool. for the rough and long wools. So the length of the wool is can ranges from 5 centimeter for fine wool and 35 centimeter for the rough or long wool. And merino wool, it is a kind of wool which is we can see in Australia. So it is an Australian wool, a merino wool. The surface of the wool fiber have scales and the cross section of the wool fibers is oval in shape. You can see here the picture. The surface of the wool fiber is have scales. See? Can everyone see the picture here? Is it clear for you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, the surface of the wool fiber have scales. You can see scales here. And the cross section of the wool is oval in shape. See, the surface of scales and cross section is oval. Okay, then the wool fiber is crimped, which gives wool and fabric the natural bulkiness and warmth. The wool fiber is compressed into small folds. In the picture, it is crimped like structure, right? Is it clear? Crimped means folds in the fabric or fiber. The crimp in wool provides airspace in the woolen fabrics. That crimp effect, no, that provides the air spaces in woolen fabrics. See, you can see the picture. In this picture, there's a woolen cushion and a shawl is here. That crimped effect is giving the airspace in the woolen fabrics. Wool absorbs moisture more than cotton. It absorbs moisture more than cotton. Wool also gives off a small steady amount of heat while absorbing moisture. It gives a small amount of heat while absorbing moisture. And this makes the wearer feel warm in the cold weather. And this property is the unique property of wool, that which when absorb moisture, they will gives off a small steady amount of heat. Okay, Steffi, can you tell the unique property of wool? What is that? What do you understood from that?
Is obtained from the fleece of domesticated sheep.
Okay, it's okay. I'm asking about the unique property. Now,
it absorbs moisture more than cotton, which makes it warm.
Okay, right. And wool fiber have less strength than cotton, but elongate more than cotton. It have less strength than cotton. Comparing to cotton, it have less strength and it elongates more than cotton. When we stretch it, it elongates. That means it have high elasticity. Okay. Have high elasticity. Wool is more resistant to acid than alkalis. It is more resistant to acid than alkalis. That's coming. Wool cannot be washed with detergents containing alkali. So dry cleaning is recommended for wool. See, it cannot be washed with alkali. So dry cleaning is recommended for wool fabrics. Okay. Exposure to sunlight and weather tends to turn wool yellow like cotton. When it is exposed to sunlight, the wool tends to turn yellow, similar to cotton due to photochemical degradation of the wool polymer. Like same like cotton itself, understood? Wool can be easily dyed with acid, reactive and metal complex dyes. It can be easily dyed with acid dye, reactive dye and metal complex dye that I will teach you in the next classes, because there is a topic of dye and I'll teach you in that, okay? So this is the cross-sectional view of wool, and that is oval in shape. And who is going to explain the properties of wool for me now? Who is Satyam? I can't see you. I don't know. Okay, so Meghna, please explain the properties of wool.
The wool fiber is obtained from the fleece of the domesticated sheep.
Okay.
And it's a natural protein fiber. And the Australian wool is known as merino wool. And the surface of wool has a large scales, and its cross section is oval.
Okay.
And it absorbs more moisture than the cotton.
Okay.
And it has high elasticity.
Okay.
And it's resistant to acids than alkalis, and dry cleaning is recommended for wool.
Wool. And
it and has
okay. Okay. Tell me.
And cotton. And because it absorbs moisture than cotton, it gives a warm.
Okay.
And it can be easily dyed with acid, react, and metal complex dyes.
Okay. Now it is understood. Now, the next natural fiber is silk. Silk is a natural protein filament obtained from filament or fiber. We can call fiber as filament also, same. Silk is a natural protein filament obtained from the cocoons of the silkworm. You can see a silk cocoon, a picture of silk cocoon here. And it is obtained from the cocoons of the silkworm. Silk is removed from the cocoon of the silkworm to give continuous length of thread, which is known as silk filament. So what is silk filament? The silk is removed from the cocoon of a silkworm to give continuous length of thread. This process is called silk filament. The raw silk strand from the cocoons consists of two silk filaments, triangular in cross section, held by a protein called sericin. Sericin, also known as silk gums. The raw silk strand from the cocoons consists of two silk filaments. So you can see the cross section of silk fiber, and sericin here. Is it clear for you, the picture? Can anyone see? Everyone see the picture?
Yes, ma'am.
The raw silk strand from the cocoon consists of two silk filaments, triangular in cross section. There are two silk filaments, they are triangular in cross section, held by a protein called sericin. This is the protein. This yellow color, you can see. That is a protein, and it is called sericin. We call it as silk gum also. Okay. And this silk gum gives a coarse handle. The sericin gives the silk a coarse handle, means a rough texture, rough handle. Okay. This silk gum can be easily removed by a process called degumming to give silk a smooth handle and bright luster. The removing of the silk gum gives a silk a smooth and bright luster. Okay, it is for this reason that rose silk is coarse in handle and lacks luster because of the silk gum, which silk gum is produced in the silk. The rose silk is, which it is very hard and it have no luster. Okay, but when it is degummed, it is soft and lustrous. Okay, understood. This is a process degum. Why degum is do degumming is doing? It is doing to give silk a smooth handle and a bright luster. Okay. Okay. What is sericin, Magna? What is sericin? What do you understand from sericin?
Sericin is the silk gum, which is in yellow color.
Okay, I can see here the. See, the raw silk of the strand of cocoon consists of two silk filaments. You can see this black triangular shape filaments. And sericin is a protein which we can see around these filaments. Right? Understood? Sericin is a protein which we held around the cross section of this, held around this triangular cross section, and this protein is called sericin or silk gum. Okay, and what is degumming? Who is going to say? Magna? No, Magna said right now. And who is going to say? Anna, can you say what is degumming?
Silk gum, the removal of silk gum, the process of removal of silk gum is called degumming.
Okay, by degumming, what we get?
It gives silk a smooth handle and bright luster.
Okay, and rose silk is coarse in handle and lacks luster. But degum silk is soft and lustrous, right? I've said it before. And the silk filament is stronger than wool. The silk filament is stronger than wool. Okay. Degum silk is soft and silk filament is very fine and regular in appearance. Silk filament is very fine and regular in appearance. Okay. Silk is easily degraded by alkalis like wool and cannot be washed by normal detergents. So it can be degraded by alkalis and it cannot be washed by detergents, normal detergents. So dry cleaning is recommended for silk. Someone have come in this class. Who all are there? Students, if I forgot to end up the class, please let me know, okay? Okay. And, okay. Now, who's going to explain the silk's properties? Who all are there? Malavika, Steffi, Sana, Anna, can you explain the properties of silk? And I didn't say the one property also. Sunlight affects silk like wool and cotton. Yeah, like cotton and wool, sunlight affects it. It becomes yellowish in color if it is not used for long period of time. Okay, so Anna, tell me the properties of silk.
Silk is a natural protein filament obtained from the cocoon of the silkworm. The raw silk strand from the cocoon consists of two silk filaments.
Okay.
Angular in cross section held by protein called
sericin.
Sericin. Silkworm can be easily removed by a process called degumming.
Degumming.
Silk smooth handle and bright luster.
Okay. Okay. By degumming, it gives silk a smooth handle and bright luster, because it will make it smoother and lustrous. Okay. By the process degumming. Okay, then. Then what are the next points, Malavika? Can you see the next points?
Silk filament is stronger than wool. Okay. A dry cleaning is recommended for silk fabrics. Sunlight affects silk like wool and cotton.
Okay. So these are the properties of silk. Okay. So we have studied the properties of some natural cellulosic fibers. So we are going to say it again. Okay. Now tell me the natural fibers again, what you have studied in this class. Who is going to tell the whole properties? Magna, can you say the natural fibers? What are natural fibers?
Natural fibers are cotton, okay, silk, jute.
Okay.
And it is obtained from the vegetable plant, animal hair, natural minerals.
Okay.
The vegetable plant plants are also from cellulosic fibers.
Okay.
And fibers are protein, which is a chemical composition.
Okay.
And the natural cellulosic fibers are cotton, flax, jute, etc.
Hemp, banana fiber, etc. Okay.
Natural protein fibers are wool, silk, camel hair, etc. And the asbestos are the naturally occurring
minerals,
which is the resistant to fire.
Okay. Okay. Then what will we have explained the properties? I think it is time to stop the class. So see you in the next class. Okay. Bye bye.